We're going to read the first through the four verses. And these things, the word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision, saying, "Fear not, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward." And Abraham said to the Lord, "What wilt thou give me, seeing that I go childless, and the steward of my house is Eliezer of Damascus?" And Abram said, "Behold to me, thou hast given no seed, and lo, one born in thy house is mine heir." And behold, the word of the Lord came to him, saying, "This is not thine heir, but he that shall come forth out of thine own bowels shall be thine heir."
Amen.
At this time, we're just going to share a word as briefly as God allows. Our topic today is wait on God.
Yes.
We can find with Abraham is before, we read in the scripture, he has some changes to go through. We've been talking about changes earlier today. He has some changes to go through. And from Abram, he became Abraham. And even his wife from Sarai became Sarah.
Yes.
Now, at one point in time, God had told them to leave. Mm-hmm. He told them to leave from their neighboring place, from out of the country where they were. Amen. He just put them on a mission to go forth. And we sometimes it seems like it's hard for us just to go forth and take God's word and do what needs to be done. Yes. But that's all he asks us. Go forth.
Go forth.
Yes. Then make that step. When he say go, just go. Don't ask no questions, just go. And sometimes we mess our own self up because we want to know what it's going to be like when we get there.
Yes.
He didn't say you had to stay there sometimes. He just said go.
Yeah.
So just take that part right there and just go.
Yeah.
So down through time, we find by the scripture, Abraham thinking, okay, I don't have any children, I'm an old man.
Oh.
In this day and time, 75 is an old man. Yep. If you're in relation to having children, producing children, reproducing children with your wife, you're considered old these days. Oh. But even with that in mind, he said that you will have an heir of your own sin.
Yeah. Yeah.
Not somebody else.
Yeah.
Yeah. I want you to remember, now he told him that. Mm-hmm. Now no doubt with him being married, he told his wife that.
All right.
Abraham.
Uh-huh.
So on down through time, we find out through the scripture that Abraham, on their journey, they had went and met Abimelech into an area. Before they got there, Abraham told them, "Now look, you need to tell him that I'm your brother."
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Now, legally, technically, and righteously, what nothing wrong with that.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
He was.
Mm-hmm.
They shared the same father.
Yeah.
They shared the same mother.
That's right. Yeah.
So it was not a total tale.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, they went on. Mm-hmm. But even Abimelech recognized through God, through the night.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. See, sometimes God can visit us at night, and the thing that he tells us
come on,
is all some kind of power. Come on.
Yes. Yes.
It's some things that he will put you in a place where you need to be if you allow him to.
Yeah.
Right. So through that night of visions and envisioning and dreaming through Abimelech, he realized, I can't do this. I got to let these people go.
Mm-hmm.
Man, why you didn't tell me that this was your wife?
Yeah.
I recognize God's presence upon you.
Yeah.
And I got enough sense not to mess with y'all.
Yeah.
If you had told me, I wouldn't have bothered y'all.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have bothered y'all at all.
Yeah.
But the good thing is that even with that, Abimelech blessed them.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He gave them the utmost of things.
Yeah.
Oxen, servants, men, servants, women.
Yeah.
And we're going to move on into that part.
Yeah.
And in the giving of things, They went on, they went to start preparing to travel on. Okay. Yeah. God had told them, go. They go on.
Yeah.
And even before it got to this point, we find that Abraham was traveling with his nephew, Lot.
With Lot.
Yeah. His family. Yes. And they had went into an area. And God is so respectful of you.
Yeah, yes. Yeah.
We need to get that same respect back to him.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because in that travel, as they told them to leave the land where Lot was, Lot and his family and them as well.
Yes.
God just said, go.
Go.
Amen. But he also told them the bag of plans. Don't look back.
Yeah.
Right.
We are messing up sometimes again.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
We looking back still. Cause I just called me this $900,000 house. And I know if I leave this house, it's personal being holy. It's personal, they're not getting it. Don't worry about it. Mm-hmm. I said, go.
Go. Yeah.
So just go. Whatever it is that you think was good for you there, God's trying to get you away from that.
Yeah.
So he can bless you into where he wants you.
Yes.
Right. And where he needs you to be.
Mm-hmm.
So just go. And from that point on, we're going to talk a little bit about the life.
All right, baby.
Sister Sarah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, we know that Abimelech gave giving them the servants. One of the servants was Hagar.
Oh, right.
Yep.
The maid.
Yeah.
Sarah said that, now, we've been around this area 10 years.
All right.
Ain't nothing happened. All right. Hang on, Jack.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You already was that old. Now you 10 years old.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm old, too.
Yeah.
I might not be as old as you, but I'm old, too.
All right. All right.
So, this is what you need to do. Take her, bear child with her.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. He was obedient.
That man gave up.
To put it normally, he was obedient.
Uh-huh.
He conceived.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
But the Lord told him, this already has said it.
Already said it. That's right.
He had told him from the beginning.
Yes, he did.
And evidently he told Sarah because Sarah knew that they needed a child for the day. And knew it was a child promise of God. So you can say for sure that she knew them.
Yeah.
But yet, we want to help God.
That's right. That's it. That's it.
How are we going to help God?
The truth.
He is everything.
Yeah.
He is the I am. I am whatever it is. That's his job.
Yeah.
I can't say that.
No.
You can't say that. Nobody out there can say that. That ain't even our vocabulary and distinctions.
Yes.
We calling ourselves, I am.
All right.
But we're going to find out that even with him doing as she had asked, trying to please the wife, trying to keep down control. You know, sometimes we women can make some noise.
That's right.
Angel.
That's right.
Sometimes we can make some noise.
Amen.
He did just what that was said of him. They conceived, but he still found out this is not the child.
That's right.
The child. This is not the child.
All right.
Even when the child was born, well, let's go back a little bit before the child was born. After Hagar had conceived, Sister Sarah got so
jealous and mad.
All right,
it needs to go.
That's
really
right.
Needs to go.
Mm-hmm.
And all of that, you know how it is. If you're in a house, you can hear somebody fuss, or you're in a place, you hear somebody talking about you.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't standing there with them, but they know you here.
Yeah.
They know you here.
Yes,
yeah. And but Hagar left. Couldn't stay. Because I am told her, go back to your bed. Go back there and dwell there. So she did just what God had said. She went back there. They had their child. And as time progressed, the child grew up. Still, not the promised child.
Amen.
Was made known. This is not the promised child.
Amen.
And in later years, you find that in the 90s, his late 90s, his end of his 90s, the child, the promised child, was conceived. And in that we find that, okay, now,
come on,
know I got this child now.
Yeah.
We don't need you no more.
Amen.
Put her out.
Yes, she did.
You put her out.
Yes.
Being a compassionate person for your child.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Even if you ain't thinking about the woman, we just gonna talk about thinking about the child.
Yeah.
It is hard to displace your child.
That's right.
That's in the natural thing. That's in the scope of nurturing as a parent.
Yeah.
It would be hard to displace your child.
Yeah.
But he did as he was told, and God told him he was gonna be all right.
Yes.
He said that even with this, I'm gonna bless him too.
Yes.
He's not your promised child,
but
I have blessed him too.
Yeah.
He's going to be fulfilled with greatness as well.
Yeah.
It didn't come to be the same thing at the same token or at the same rate or whichever speed you want to call it for Isaac, which was the child of promise, but he blessed them too. And even when Isaac came along, as children often do, some conflict, and the conflict didn't stop there in the young age.
Conflict
carried on generational. Even when Isaac grew up and got married.
Right.
And had child.
Yes.
So conflict is still carrying on.
Yes.
Now let's back up a little bit. Even at that point, God had still shown them, I'm going to bless one that bless you. He had already told them.
Right.
I'm going to encourage you. And just go out there and do what I asked you to do. And we find even with Abraham, this wasn't his only test to put the child Ishmael out. He had another test. The test we talk about more often than any of them was when he had to sacrifice take him up to the mountain. Take sacrificial things with you.
That's
Even the child recognized
sure did. Don't rush for anything. But I'll keep on waiting
because I don't want to miss my blessing.
Oh, yeah.
Everything is going to come to me at the right time.
Right.
Yes. All I got to do is let my light shine.
Yeah.
That's what I want to leave with you.
Yeah.
Regardless of where you're going, all of you, my family, all of you, my friends, whether you biological or picked up along the way, co-workers, everything, everybody in here, my family.
Right.
And I appreciate you being here today. And just remember, whatever God has for you to do, whatever He set you out for to do, you can't accomplish that on your own anyway.
That's right.
You just can't accomplish that by yourself. You've got to have Him be in charge of it. And obedience.
Right.
You have to be obedient.
Yeah.
If you're not obedient in what He asked you to do, it didn't mean that He was going to take it from you, but your path of getting there will be slow. You can slow yourself down.
Yeah.
You make yourself worried for nothing because He says go over here on the left side. And you start it off. It might be just that simple. It seems weird, but sometimes it's just that simple. God don't put no whole lot of up way level stuff on us. He put everything in front of us in simple terms. All we got to do is walk out there and do it. And the last thing I want to say to you, all you have to do, just do your part.
All right.
Then you wait on God.
Amen.
Amen.